Hello friends, are you ready for another adventure? I hope you are, because today we're traveling to the beautiful European country, Switzerland, also known as the Swiss Confederation. If you want to learn more about Switzerland, don't forget to download the activity pack in the description below. You can also watch our videos about the Matterhorn and Swiss chocolate. Now let's get on with the video. Switzerland is located in Central Europe, bordered by Germany to the north, Liechtenstein to the east, Italy to the south, and France to the west. Although it has no official capital, its parliament, government, and foreign embassies are located in Bern. So if you ask anyone in Switzerland, they'll probably tell you Bern is the country's capital. Switzerland is separated into 26 cantons. In case you're wondering, cantons are like states or provinces. Switzerland is located right in the middle of the Alps mountain range. About 60% of Switzerland's territory is mountainous regions. This is not ideal for living. That's why the majority of the population lives in the northern side of the country known as the Swiss Plateau. But before we talk about the beautiful Switzerland landscapes, let's talk about symbols like the flag. The Swiss flag displays a white cross with equilateral arms right in the center of the red square. The cross is simply known as the Swiss cross, and it represents the same Christian cross symbol, while the red field represents the old Confederacy. The Swiss flag is one of only two square sovereign state flags. The other one is Vatican City's flag. What about the language? Well, due to the four countries surrounding Switzerland, it has four official languages: German, French, Italian, and Romansh. Wait a minute, what's Romansh? Don't worry, most people don't know about this language. It's because it's a local dialect spoken only in the southeast of Switzerland. And although only 0.5% of the population speaks Romansh, it's still considered a national language. The most spoken languages in Switzerland are the German and French by more than 80% of the population. To say hello in German, we say hallo or guten tag. Do you know how we say hello in French? Bonjour. Yes, say it with me. Bonjour. Now that you know how to greet Swiss people, let's talk about them. A lot of foreigners who visit Switzerland will say the country feels like a small village. That's because most people are very friendly and they greet each other all the time. But probably the most recognizable trait of the Swiss people is that they take punctuality very seriously. They think that a punctual person is considerate and very respectful towards other people. Hey, probably that's why they make the best watches in the world. Speaking of Swiss-made products, do you know what a Swiss champ is? No, it's not a champion from Switzerland. It's that multi-tool pocket knife maybe you've seen in your parents' tool shed. It's mostly known as the Swiss Army Knife, but that's not its real name. It's just what American soldiers called it, because they couldn't pronounce the German word, which is Offiziersmesser, which means officer's knife. This handy tool has not only a knife, but also a pair of scissors, screwdriver, can opener, wood saw, and more. But remember, although it looks fun to use, this is not a toy, and you shouldn't use it without your parents' help. Now let's talk about some of the most beautiful things in Switzerland. Its amazing landscapes and landmarks. The Matterhorn is not only a great example of natural beauty, but also a great example of adventure. It's the most famous of all the mountains that make up the Alps, and although it's not the tallest one, at about less than 15,000 feet high, it's still quite high. With millions of people traveling to see the Matterhorn and many local climbers climbing it each year, we can say it is probably the most iconic peak in the world. The Chillon Castle, known in French as the Château de Chillon, it used to be the residence of the Counts of Savoy for nearly four centuries, but now it's one of Switzerland's biggest tourist attractions. Each year, more than 400,000 guests visit the beautiful castle that consists of 25 buildings and three courtyards. If you want to visit it, it's located next to the Lake of Geneva in Montreux. And speaking of lakes, we can't forget about the Rhine Falls, Europe's largest waterfalls, at approximately 15,000 years old with a width of 492 feet and a height of 75.5 feet. It's no wonder why it's so popular. These majestic falls are located on the border between the cantons of Schaffhausen and Zurich. Just like Bern, the unofficial capital of Switzerland, Zurich is a beautiful city full of classic architecture and historic buildings. But there is something that differentiates Zurich, not only from other cities in Switzerland, but also from any other city in the world. According to several surveys, Zurich has the highest quality of life compared to anywhere else in the world. As soon as you get there, you'll see why. Just don't forget to visit the old town of Altstadt. But we can't talk about Switzerland's landscapes and nature without mentioning the names of the animals who live there, can we? Since Switzerland is a country with mostly cold weather, every animal here is always looking for a warm place to rest, and no animal does it better than the European mole. These furry friends are found in every corner of Europe, from England to Russia. They like to spend their whole life underground, away from predators and light. Have you ever heard of the expression blind as a mole? Well, it's kind of funny because moles aren't blind at all. Remember when I mentioned that more than half of Switzerland's territory is mountainous regions and it's hard for people to live there? Well, these horned animals have no problem living in the mountains. The Alpine ibex is a goat, easily distinguished because of its long, curved horns. This animal was hunted to extinction about 2 centuries ago in Switzerland. Fortunately, it was reintroduced in the early 1900s, and now there are about 40,000 of them in the Swiss Alps. Now look at this cute little friend. The mountain hare is a species of hare family that lives in the mountains and polar habitats. You can find them in the Alps, but you can barely see them because of their white fur that blends them into the snow. Another great example of Swiss wildlife is the bearded vulture. And yes, it's called that because of the little beard it has under its beak. It's known by the locals as Lemmegeier, which translates to lamb vulture. Now that we've talked about some of the animals in Switzerland, let's talk about what Swiss people do. Specifically, what kind of sports they like. Switzerland's national sport is the Schwingen, but it's a Swiss form of traditional wrestling. Wait, is it like the wrestling we've seen on television? Actually, no, but they do wrestle in a ring, a round ring covered with sawdust. Let me explain. The two apparent opponents wear short pants made of jute over their clothes. They hold each other by these pants and try to throw the opponent onto his back. The match is won when the winner holds up the opponent's pants with at least one hand and both opponents' shoulders touch the ground. The most important Schwing festival is the Eidgenössische Schwing und Alpenfest, which takes place every 3 years. The winner of this tournament is proclaimed Schwingekönig and receives a bull as his prize. Yes, that's right, not a medal or a trophy, but a bull. That's crazy. Some other very popular sports in Switzerland are ice hockey, skiing, football, tennis, and basketball. Phew, talking about sports and Schwing got me hungry. Let's see some classic Swiss food, like the Swiss fondue. Switzerland is well known for its delicious cheese, but when you melt it, it's even better. Most Swiss fondues are made with Gruyere and other cheese such as Emmental. Fondue is served in a petite ceramic pot called the Cauquelon with a burner underneath that keeps its temperature constant. Another classic and tasty dish is the Alpenmaigronin. This super pasta was invented in the 1930s by farmers in the Alps, and its ingredients include not only pasta, but also potatoes, cheese, fried onions, and garlic. It's often served with stewed apples. Imagine that. But what about dessert? Switzerland has great desserts. One great example is the Wundernusstorte, which is a caramelized nut-filled pastry pie that originates from the canton Graubünden. The best part is that you can find it in basically every bakery in Switzerland. I know what you're thinking. What about the Swiss chocolate? It's no wonder why so many people consider Swiss chocolate as one of the best in the world. The Alpine regions are home to creamy, rich milk, which is the key to making chocolate with silky consistency. The oldest factory in the country is the Maison Keiler, whose name is almost synonymous with Swiss chocolate. Other great chocolate factories are the Maestranis Chocolarium, House of Liederach, and the Camille Bloch Chocolate Factory. Now that we're so full of energy thanks to all that Swiss chocolate, it's time for some fun. And what better way to have fun than skiing? As you may know, thanks to the Alps' high peaks and cold climate, Switzerland is one of the best places to enjoy winter activities, including skiing. There are several resorts in Switzerland that offer sledding, snow parks, cross-country skiing, paragliding, heli-skiing, and more. Now let's talk about what kind of music Swiss people like to listen to. Swiss people not only like mainstream pop, rock, and hip-hop, but just like every other country in the world, but they also are huge fans of American country music and Schlager, which is simply love songs in German language. However, if we talk about music, we can't ignore traditional Swiss folk music such as Alphorn music, Ländler, and classic Jodeling. The most known musical instruments used in Swiss folk music are the accordion, known in Switzerland as the Schweizer Regoli, the violin, bass, clarinet, and also the Alphorn, which is a huge wooden horn. It was originally used for communication in most mountainous regions of Europe, but now they're used as musical instruments. Let's talk just a little bit more about Jodeling. You've probably heard this one before, also very popular in Germany. Jodeling is a form of singing which involves repeated and rapid changes of pitch between the low and high pitch. It was originally used mainly by shepherds to communicate with each other while being in the mountains. There are still Jodeling festivals being held to this day. Speaking of traditions, did you know that in Switzerland there's a tradition where people show their best horses? Yes, that's right. In Seignelage, during summer, Horse enthusiasts converge and show their thoroughbred horses and their prowess. There's also the traditional onion market in Bern. In November, you'll find this market where you can buy, well, onions. Onions of all color and size, in braids, clusters, red, white, and even wrapped up as sweets for every food lover out there. Yeah, I know, maybe you're not the biggest onion fan, but what about Christmas? Switzerland shares many of the customs from its neighbors Germany and Austria, but its Swiss people have many traditions of their own, like in the Bernese Oberland region, where they have processions called Treischle, which last from Christmas Day until New Year's Eve. In these processions, people wear a big Treischler, cowbell, and masks as they walk through the streets, making lots of noise with drums. This is meant to scare the evil spirits away. Santa Claus also visits Switzerland, but he does it on December 6th, and he's known as Samich Klaus. You might receive some presents from the baby Jesus, or Father Christmas, on the 25th, and on January 6th by the Befana, or Three Kings. That's a lot of present bringers. Christmas in Switzerland is something magical, but if you're not interested in winter sports or don't like cold weather that much, you can visit the country between April and October. This is the best time to visit Switzerland because of the warmer weather. You rarely get any humidity thanks to the high altitude. And that's Switzerland, a beautiful country full of rich culture, delicious chocolate, and really amazing landscapes. Don't forget to check the weather before planning your trip. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe for more amazing adventures. Auf Wiedersehen, au revoir, and ciao, friends!